letter, Shirley?
Yes, Mommy. All three for you.
Telephone bill. I wonder how much this month. Wow! $624.51. This computer must be mad. Give me a man any time instead of a machine.
Watch your words, Mommy.
I was talking about these computers. This letter from Denise in the States and a circular from the Soroptimist Club. And Shirley, what about the one you were reading at the gate?
What letter?
The one you put in your bosom.
So you were minding my business, eh?
No, I was looking through the window. You read something and you put it in your bosom.
Mommy, I don't think that...
I want to see it, Shirley.
All right, if you insist. But brace yourself for a shock.
Shirley Wells, your father was in the Superstar Cinema last night with Carol Parker. They kissed all the time during the picture. I felt he was lying all the time. Whoever wrote this knows both of them.
Yes, and know me too and want to hurt me.
I just feel to pack up all my things and leave this house.
Where you will go?
I'll go by my sister.
That wouldn't work. Just forget everything as if nothing happened.
But I can't.
You must. That's what most women your age do. Pretend not to know about it.
No. One of us have to go. It is better for him to go.
There is still something else.
What?
You could give that girl competition.
You mean slim down? New hairstyle, mud dress.
But Mommy, if you want to keep him, you have to do something.
I don't care two hoots about losing him. I'm not gonna dress up myself in any stupid boy George fashion, pretending I'm young just to keep him. If he was Sidney Poitier or Muhammad Ali, I might have gone through the trouble. But for Arthur Wells, no way.
Good morning, Mrs. Wells. I have an important message for you.
You again? Why you don't leave me alone?
Who was that, Mommy?
The same man who called the other day.
Oh, the one who told you about Daddy?
Yes, the crook. I'll fix him good.
Mommy, he might feel you're afraid to face up to the truth.
Good morning, Wells residents.
It's me. I'm here again. And don't slam down the phone.
What I do? Why are you only persecuting me like this?
My intention is not to persecute you, but to enlighten you. You've been in the dark too long. It's time you know what's happening in your life.
All right. What it is this time?
Last night, around 11:30, your husband was up Lady Chancellor Hill with the same woman.
So what? Why tell me? Like you want to make my life unhappy or what?
On the contrary, I want to make you happy.
How?
You can get a divorce.
Divorce?
Why not? You'll receive a very good alimony and you can get married again if you wish.
Not at my age. Who are you? Some kind of detective or something?
Just call me a friend.
I don't understand this at all. How you could know his whereabouts like this?
I just happened to be in the right place at the right time. I was relaxing with a girl at the lookout.
You are just as no good as my husband.
Ah, but there is a difference. I am not married, Mrs. Wells. Bye for now.
Yes, Shirley. After your father took Carol Parker to the cinema last night, they ended up on the Lady Chancellor Hill.
That mystery man seemed to know a lot.
He's dangerous. He suggested I divorce your father.
I don't like that too much. What do you want to do?
I'll confront him with the evidence as soon as he comes home for lunch.
Please, Mommy, leave me out this time. The whole thing's so embarrassing.
Shirley, I need you here as a silent witness.
Oh, well, whatever you want.
spell this one with me?
Yes, me Danny.
How you know my name?
Good. First you get and come in now.
Any dogs?
Nah man, I'm the only one will bite you.
How you know me? Just seen my person?
I used to see her with that girl from Cascade, Shirley, where else?
How you know her?
I used to work for her mother, but now I'm working in that office.
Yeah, Shirley and me couldn't make it, so I send her packing.
Yes, and you're living with a big fat bubble ups in the yard.
Don't bother with that.
Both of you went to pictures the night before.
Oh, you know all these things about me.
I just see your eyes all.
I know a lot about you too. Your name is Carol Parker, and you're going around with Shirley's father.
You're a spy or something?
Well, he was kissing all through the picture.
That is a lie.
I saw him.
He was kissing me all the time, but I was looking at the picture.
And so with these old men.
I suppose it's the same with your old woman.
Don't bother with that. It's me and Mabel not in Borough. She just gave me meals since I'm not working. That is all.
You should have a better mind than that.
Pressure girl. No job, no money, no food.
In spite of that, you're looking good. Anyhow, I have to go and get ready for a date tonight. I'll see you.
Gosh, I'm not beginning to enjoy wrapping up here.
All right. Come and see me tomorrow.
What time?
Around this time, I'll be right here waiting for your dad.
That's a date. Bye, Carl.
Bye, Daddy.